Hello, my beautiful people. Today, I will tell you how to host an Airbnb experience. How to offer the best experience to your guests, or how to be the best host. In the place where I'm living, Airbnb started experiences just a year ago. So I have been hosting Airbnb experiences just for 1 year, but I have been getting many more bookings than I first expected. And of course, it's a very good thing and I'm so happy about it. On Airbnb, once you have hosted experience, the guests will leave you a feedback and they will leave you also a vote, which will be from 1 to 5 and the maximum will be 5. And of course, all those experiences which will have 5 stars will be always on the first page. And of course also people will be more happy to book them because they can see that other people they have already had very good experiences. To be a good host, people like you when you're talkative. For example, you can just ask questions about your guests, where they're coming from, some questions about the city where they're from, or also about the work, if they're doing something interesting. And people love talking about themselves. And like this, you can also show your interest about them. And of course, I hope you will be sincerely interested about them, as I am usually, because I love meeting new people and also new cultures. Another very important thing is that please write out everything that you're going to do in your experience, which means that there shouldn't be any additional costs. If there is, please write it always out, otherwise you will get the negative feedback. If there are any special places where you're going or you're not going, please write it out. If there is anything with the transportation that you are offering or you're not offering, always write it out. Because as soon as there's something a little bit negative that your guests didn't expect at first, they will immediately leave you a negative feedback. And of course, it won't help you to continue in a good way your experience. I think a very nice thing to do to your guests is to offer something to drink or to eat. It should be something very simple, like a coffee or a little snack or sweet. If you have something typical or traditional to your country, then definitely make them to try it. Maybe you can even explain the story about that typical thing, and I'm sure your guests will love it. And of course, it doesn't need to be something really expensive. It doesn't need to be a dinner, but just offer a small thing and you will see that your guests will be very, very happy about it. My most booked experience is the creative travel video experience, which means that I'm making the videos to the people who are coming to visit my city. And also I'm showing around them in the city some hidden gems, or also I'm making to try them some traditional sweets. And also I love all the curious facts about my city. So of course, before your very first experience, you should study some facts about the place where you're living if you don't know them yet. Or just some fun things to know, because of course people will love to hear the stories that they didn't know before. Everybody's asking how to get 5 stars feedback. You need to do everything that I was saying before. Just be very friendly, try to be very kind to your guests. And for example, I like to say to my guests that if they need any help with where to eat or where to go in my city or in my country, I will be always ready to help them. And just, they always need to feel free to write me or to contact me. And I just try to be very available for them. After hosting many experiences, be ready that not all your guests will leave you feedback. And it can even happen because they were always traveling and they didn't have enough time, they didn't have the internet connection, because they will have 30 days after the end of the experience to leave you a feedback. And usually if I see after a week that my guests haven't left a feedback to me, then I contact them and I write them saying, I'd really appreciate if you could take time to leave just one word about this experience. It will really help me to continue this experience. And really, if they could leave me just one word and just their vote, which I always, of course, I hope it will be 5 stars, then it will always help me to continue my experience. Some people will notice that it's not possible to host an experience in the place where they're living. And it means that Airbnb hasn't started yet the experiences in your city. And usually what you can do is to contact Airbnb asking that is it possible to start experience in the place where you want to start it. And usually after the Airbnb gets many requests about one place, they will start it also over there. Because in a place place where I'm living as I told before, they started it just 1 year ago, but I saw on their site that it was possible to host experiences in other cities already 2-3 years ago, and I was so much hoping and praying that really soon it will come to my city. I was also writing to Airbnb and I needed to have a little bit patience, and finally I'm able to host these experiences, and I'm always thinking that I would love to host more experiences because I have so many different things that I would love to offer to my guests, to the people who are coming to visit my city. And it's also really so fun to meet all those people from all around the world with all the different cultures and languages. It's just so exciting for me. Please note that hosting an experience through Airbnb will have also some costs for you, which means the Airbnb fees. The Airbnb fees for experiences are 20% of the cost that you're putting out on the site of Airbnb. So if the price of my experience is 100 euros, it means that Airbnb will take 20%, which will be 20 euros, and I will get 80. So please consider this always every time you're deciding the right price for your experience. Another tip how to get more bookings, especially if you're just starting, is to put a little bit lower price. Because at first, if you're trying to get the very good high price, then unfortunately people won't book you, because if you don't have enough feedbacks, then they don't know if really all this money will be worth to pay for this kind of experience. So people want to be always sure that once they're paying out this money, it will be worth it. So try to put a little bit lower price at first, and then after getting the first feedbacks, you can raise the price. And that's exactly how I have been doing, and I'd say it has been really working. I got my very first feedbacks with quite low price, but after that I was able to ask the price that I wanted, and now it's going really, really well. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions about how to be a better host on Airbnb or how to host an Airbnb experience, please write your questions down here in the comments, and I'd really appreciate if you could subscribe this channel, put the thumbs up, and come back here very soon again.